Hello everyone, once again I'll welcome you in my YouTube channel. Today we are going to see the practice set 5.1 from the quadrilateral chapter from maths 2. This practice set, it is based on the properties of a quadrilateral, that is parallelogram. So let's study the examples which is based on the properties of a parallelogram. For the practice set, I will explain you what is the property of a parallelogram. So here, this is parallelogram. Property of a parallelogram related with the sides. Parallelograms opposite sides are congruent. Means AD is congruent with BC and AB is congruent with DC. So here we can say that opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. In the same way, related with the angles. Angles, opposite angles are congruent. Means here angle B is congruent with D and angle C is congruent with A. So what about this D and C? What is the relation of D and C and A and B? If opposite angles are congruent, then if you talk about the adjacent angle, so that is A and B, these two angles are supplementary. Means their sum is 180 degree. Now we will talk about the diagonals. Diagonal AC and diagonal BD are the bisectors of each other. So they intersect with each other and they make the equal parts. In this first example from practice set 5.1, diagonals of a parallelogram W, X, Y, Z, they intersect each other at point O. They intersect each other at point O. Then we have X, Y, Z, this angle. This angle's measurement is given 135 degree. Then what is the measure of the X, W, Z? X, W, Z. Means we want to find out the opposite angle of this. And Y, Z, W. Y, Z, W. Means here we have to find opposite angle and adjacent angles. Then length of OY. OY, it is a half part of this diagonal. So OY is given 5 cm. We want to find out the measurement of a diagonal WY. Now we'll see the solution. So what is given? Angle XYZ. XYZ, it is given 135 degree. I will write here reason. I want to find out angle XWZ. XWZ, which is opposite of this. So which property I have explained you related with the opposite angles of a parallelogram? Opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. So here I'll write the property. Opposite angles of parallelogram are congruent, therefore their measurements will be equal. Means angle XYZ is equal with the angle XWZ. Their measurements would be same. Means if it is 35 degree, its measurement is also 35 degree. So therefore, angle XWZ's measurement is also 135 degree. Because angle XYZ is equal to 135 degree. We have got now first angle. Now we'll go for the YZW. YZW, it is an adjacent angle of this. So adjacent angles are supplementary. Adjacent angles are supplementary means their measurements, if you add it, then you will get the answer 180 degree. Means your angle X, Y, Z plus angle Y, Z, W is equal to 180 degree. Means XYZ plus y, z, w, their measurements. If you add it, you will get the 180 degree. It is, this measurement, it is given 135 degree. Plus, we want to find out this angle. We'll keep it as it is equal to 180 degree. Transfer this on that side. So, angle y, z, w is equal to 180 degree minus 135 degree. And if you subtract it, you will get the answer 45 degree. Now we will find out the diagonal WY. Here they have given OY, it is 5 cm. What is the relation of OY with the WY? It is the half of that, because we know the property of a diagonals. Diagonals are bisector of each other. They make the equal parts of each other. So here, diagonals are bisectors of each other. That means OY is nothing but half of this WY. OY's measurement is given 5 cm, 1 upon 2 multiplied by WY. 2 transfer it here, so 5 multiplied by 2 is equal to WY. That means WY, measurement of a diagonal, it is 10 cm. Second example, in a parallelogram, two angles are given, A angle and B angle, and we have to find out the C angle and D angle. So here I will draw the figure. A angle and B angle, C and D. Measurements are given, A angle is 3x plus 12. Your B angle is given 2x minus 32. In the information, they gave the adjacent angles. Adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. So, using this property, what do you mean by supplementary? Their sum is 180 degree. Means here angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. त्यांची addition किती येते? 180 degree येते. A ची value काय? 3x plus 12 plus B's value is 2x minus 32 is equal to 180 degree. Open the bracket, bracket open kara. So 3x plus 12 plus, because of plus sign asliamule bracket madle signs change honar nahi, terms jashe cha tashe, 2x minus 32 is equal to 180 degree. 3x plus 2x, like terms, their addition, so 5x ena, plus 12 minus 32. Signs are different, so here we have to subtracted sign of bigger number. So, answer would be 20, 180 degree. 20 transfer on that side. So, 5x, 20 tikade gela nantar 180 madhe add hoin plus 20. So, 5x is equal to 200. So, what is x value? Now, we want to find out x value. So, x is equal to 200 upon 5, that if you divide it, you will get the answer 40 degree. X ची value आली, angles ची value नाही. म्हणजे इथे angles ची value कशी find out करणार? ही x ची value या angles च्या expressions मध्ये घातले की आपल्याला angle A आणि angle B मिळेल. So we will write here, what is angle A? A angle काय आहे? तर 3x plus 12. A ची value, x ची value, x value is 40 degree. So, we will write here 3 into 40 plus 12. 3 4s are 12. So, 120 plus 12. So, we will get the answer 132 degree. Angle A is equal to 132. Now we will find out the angle B. Angle B, it is 2x minus 32. 2 multiplied by x value is 40 degree. Minus 32, it is 80 minus 32. What is the answer? If you will subtract, we will get the answer 0 minus 2, it is 8. 8 minus 4, it would be 48 degree. Means angle B is equal to 48 degree. But what do we want to find out? We want to find out the angle C and D. If you observe the figure, angle A opposite angle is C. Means their measurements are same. Right here, angle A is equal to angle C. Therefore, angle C is equal to 132 degrees. Angle B and angle D are equal. Angle B congruent with angle D. B's measurement is 48 degrees, so angle D is also 48 degrees. Which property I have used here? By property of opposite angles of a parallelogram. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. So by using this property, I have got the measurements of angle C and angle D. In third example, they have given the perimeter of a parallelogram. What is the concept of a perimeter of a parallelogram? Perimeter means it is the total length of a parallelogram. Means it is the sum of all sides of a parallelogram. Now here we know the property of a sides of the parallelogram. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are always congruent. Here they gave the relation. One side, it is greater than the other side by 25 centimeters. For example, if I have considered this quadrilateral, and this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. And here, I will consider one side, means AB is a x. X, so it would be x plus 25. Manje, ek side is a x asel, the dusri side kaya hai, the 25 ne greater ahe. Manje, he is a x asel, the he side kaya asnar x plus 25. So, solution, the perimeter of a parallelogram dilela ahe, to ahe 150. By using this information, we are going to find out the value of x first. Maithe, apan ek consider kariya, let ABCD is a parallelogram. इते काय कंसीडर केला है? AB is equal to X. So, AB is equal to X. So, what is the other side? दूसरी side का है? तो 25 ने greater है. So, BC is equal to X plus 25. Now, here, by the property of a perimeter, by definition of perimeter, that is sum of all sides, is equal to AB plus BC plus CD plus AD is equal to 150 degree. AB we have considered X. BC guy man liye X plus 25. X plus 25. So here also X plus 25. Opposite sides are congruent. This is X, so this is also X. Put the values here. BC is X plus 25. CD का है, CD, it is also X, AD, X plus 25 is equal to 150 degree. Here, I have used the property of a sides. Property of a sides of the parallelogram says that opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. So, X, 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 4 times X. So, here we will get 4X, 4X value. 25 plus 25, 50. Is equal to 150 degree. 50 transfer there. So 150 minus 50. 4x subtraction, we will, after subtracting, we will get the answer 100. Transfer 4 on that side. So x is equal to 100 upon 4, that means 25 centimeter. X value is 25 centimeter. What is AB? AB is equal to X. Manjas can 25 centimeter. AB 25, so AB is equal to CD. So CD's value is also 25 centimeter. AB we have got, CD we have got. Now we will find out BC. BC guy, BC is equal to X plus 25. X value 25. So I'll put it here. 25 plus 25, 50 centimeter. BC and AD are the opposite sides. So BC is equal to AD. That means AD's value is also 50 centimeter. Fourth example. In this example, they have given the ratios of measures of two adjacent angles of this parallelogram. What is the ratio? 1 is to 2. So here we have to use the common multiple. Then we'll get the values of those angles. It is x and 2x. So find the measures of all the angles of the parallelogram. Means I have to find out the angle. All four angles we have to find out. So let the common multiple be x. So therefore, angle A is to B. It is given 1 is to 2. If I consider this is a quadrilateral which is a parallelogram, then A is to B, angle's measurement, it is given 1 is to 2. So here, if I use the common multiple X, so angle A would be X and angle B is equal to 2X. These two angles are the adjacent angles of a parallelogram. So property says that adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplementary. So by using the property, by adjacent angles of parallelogram are supplementary, means angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Angle A is X plus 2X is equal to 180 degree. Their addition is 3X is equal to 180 degree. 3 transfer it here. So X is equal to 180 degree upon 3. And if you divide it, you will get the answer 60 degree. So X value is 60 degree. Now we will find out the angles. Angle A is equal to X I have considered, and X value I have got 60 degree. So angle A is equal to 60 degree. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent with each other. So angle A is congruent with angle C. Means their measurements are same. So angle A is 60 degree, so angle C is also 60 degree. Therefore, angle C is equal to 60 degree. Now we'll find out the B angle. Angle B's measurement is 2x we have considered, because these I have considered x and this would be 2x. So 2x means 2 multiplied by x value we have got 60 degree. That means angle B is equal to 120 degree. Angle B and angle D are opposite angles. So angle B congruent with angle D is equal to 120 degree. So in this way, by using the property of opposite angles are congruent, I have found remaining angles. Angle C is equal to 60 degree. Angle D is 120 degree. So students, in this way, we have completed the examples which are based on the properties of a parallelogram. I hope you have understood all the examples. These examples are not only useful for the standard 9, but also this is useful for the standard 8 and standard 10th also. If you like the video, please don't forget to subscribe the channel and share this video with your friends. Thank you.